So what we're going to do is we're going to do a little bit of storytelling, a little storytelling. I listen to a lot of your shelter bits, and a couple of things to think about when we do storytelling is part of our job when we build these shelters is to tell a story with the shelter. So when we tell a story, we need to pay attention to what the person is saying. We also need to pay attention to how they're saying it. What I want you to do is I want you to look at your partner, grab your partner. I'm going to give you something to tell your partner. Your partner is you're going to pay attention to everything I am saying, but also how I'm saying it, okay? And then after about a minute, I'm going to stop, and James, who's going to be my partner, is going to tell the story back to me as me. So I'll model this with James, and what Job is going to do is we're going to pick an embarrassing story. So you're going to tell the person an embarrassing moment. They're then going to tell it back to you, and then you're going to switch. So you paid in?
Yeah.
Good. So 6-7 years ago, I was teaching a 10th grade class, and this is when like really skinny jeans were really like kind of in.
Oh, I've heard a story.
I know. Well, it's the same one I told before, but it's an embarrassing story. So anyway, I'm teaching a class, and I'm getting into it, and I'm all like, been doing my thing about whatever the class, Tale of Two Cities, I don't really remember what it was about. But I remember I was going up to a student who was working on something, and I did one of the, I was like crouched down by the desk to like talk, and the pants just totally ripped completely. And I'm just going about my business, and nobody notices, and I back slowly out of the room, I go down to the costume room, change pants, come back in, keep teaching. Nobody noticed.
Not
I split my pants in front of
him. I was teaching 10th grade English, and it was something about a book about a tale, two stories, or something like that. No, I can't really remember. And I walk up to a student, and I had to crouch down to talk to her like this. And all of a sudden, my pants just rip. Nobody notices, so I back out very slowly. I go downstairs to the costume room, I change my pants, and I come right back up.
So I was like, I was 14 years old, and I was at my friend Marissa's pool party. And like, there was a good group of like 20 of my friends there. Like basically friends of friends were there. It was just like a crazy pool party we were having. It was actually like a sleepover, but like we were all sleeping in the basement. And at like 5 o'clock in the morning, we decided to go swimming. I jump in the pool, the water is freezing. But then when I get out of the pool, my swim shorts didn't come up with me. And I'm just in my underwear in front of all my friends sitting there and wondering why they're looking at me like that. And yeah.
So ever since I got these shoes, I walked a lot in them, and I would walk in the hall, and I was going to my class, and then I would trip, and then I would trip with the thing that no one notices. But today I tripped like 3 times, but no one notices. So. And that's all I remember.
No. Put it away.
Two sort of things we're going to focus today a little bit is how to tell a story. And part of it is when we talk about shelter, particularly in terms of refugees, is in some respects we are telling stories of people that aren't us. So how do we do it authentically and honestly? So that's one of the things that I really wanted to stress that. It's hard to do that. You make decisions, you really gotta be attentive. So even if you might get their story wrong, the facts wrong, you don't want to. I think of James's story, he missed the skinny jeans part. So that story, you know, it's okay, you missed the detail. But he picked up on the other detail, which was kind of the humor of walking out of the room, how they tell it. So you're always making choices when you tell someone else a story about what to include, what not to include. That's really important. How was it seeing yourself portrayed back at you? If we were to interview people, who might we want to interview, considering you're reading from the last couple of days or listening, to get some perspectives on this topic, to hear sort of a complete story rather than just one story? This is open for the discussions. So one example, first one, is we might actually hear for someone who was a refugee. Who else might we want to hear?
Okay.
Yes.
The people that live in the place where the refugees aren't.
So people who live in sort of countries where people are fleeing.
Like someone who's like having, like an American who's having trouble getting a job, because like a lot of people say refugees are taking up our jobs.
Right. You have these materials and these building materials, and by the end of class tomorrow, you have to build a little shelter for your little pipe cleaner person, and everybody's going to present and tell a story of why that pipe cleaner person needs shelter.
What's going on here? Do you know what you're building yet?
Yes. What are you building?
A documentary. Wow, making progress, Caroline.
Ball it on a budget.
This is gonna be the wall. We're gonna put it under like this.
Smart.
So it's sturdy, what? You know? No. So this is our finished project.
Should I cut into here?
Yeah. Wait, try 3 inches off each side.
What is that going to be?
Is this hard?
I don't know.
Is it that street job?
On Friday, you need to...
You know how big he is?
No,
I'm
just
kidding. Just kind of like
really
thoughts.
Okay.
This is Richard. Richard's great. His hands were blown off in some sort of incident. I don't know. And so we don't have a door. So we have a little ribbon there, because if you don't have hands, how are you gonna open the door? And so he has a bed in there. He's fine. And I was absent for the building, but there. That's my shelter. Our shelter.
Our gingerbread people, they spawned in Candyland, and to get away from the grizzlies, aka the gummy bears, they had to build a home. Took them a while because they were constantly on the run from the grizzlies, but they made this.
Yeah, they have a little fire to keep warm.
Yeah, and some beds.
Yeah.
And then like these things are like licorice and like gingerbread stuff.
Yeah.
Keep it like insulated in the winter time.
Our guy's name is Jerry. When he went to Switzerland, he went camping with his friends for a week in the woods, but it was the winter. He got lost, and in the woods he found his future wife, Olga, who is of Viking descent, and she ran away from her family with her feminist views.
So they're in Switzerland, so that's the flag, and it's
It's kind of levitating because like they don't want the animals to get in it. So, but they don't also don't want the house floating away. So you need these to like tie it down to the ground.
Name is Rudd Paul. Inside his house, he has a bed, a stove / oven, a refrigerator, a sink in his kitchen, a shower, a toilet, and another sink.
Works in an office in Seattle, but he's a really bad telemarketer, so he doesn't make a lot of money. He's like a really bad salesperson. That's why he's really sad.
You are not like going to be a refugee. It's not like, hello, I'm going to be a refugee for a week. However, you're going to give, you are given materials to construct a shelter for you and your family or group. The shelter must provide the basic necessities for you. We'll be sharing this, the shelter in the scary hallways.
Too hard because like you have, I think he's not gonna have that made into a circular form.
Yeah. That we're looking at least
no, but yeah. Makes it even if it's only like 6¾.
We only have about 5 days, 6 days to build this. Don't use electricity.
Hearing weird sounds.
You can use this back room a little bit to build. Please don't. I give you wood. If you actually need something more wood, let me know. Again, ask. But here are screws and nails.
How was it, Ed?
No comment.
Get away from my group, Mia. Yeah. Before I measure.
Cut it, cut it, cut it, cut it, cut it.
Yes, it's Mia!
Go, Brit! Why are you nailing in a screw?
Because every time I put the freaking screw in the screwdriver goes and fall right off the screw, and I'm sick of it, and I'm James, but he's doing good, and I'm angry.
Mia.
Yeah?
My pants are dirty.
Yeah, that's, it's called work, James.
I'm crying.
Like fold it into like one.
We have a hinge here, here, and here. Then
if you fold
this will go inwards. So then
what happens to the outside?
What do you mean what happens to the outside?
Like it'll just
this folds.
It's on all four, yeah.
This folds like into like this, so then there's two blocks like this.
You only technically have three class periods left. So be thinking about this. People went really quickly to the wood as the stabilizing material. Not a bad idea, but I'm just saying, as you think about this, spend some time with how tight is that tarp and that clear wrap? Could that be manipulated in a way to also help do support and stabilizing material so we're not so reliant on this?
So this is our structure.
Yeah.
This is some design right here on the side. And these are our measurements right here, so we can apply it to our structure and our shelter. You know, we have all the beams going across into the middle. We have the tarp right here all set up. It's color-coded. It's wonderful. Now all we have to do is put it together.
We're gonna get nothing done by doing that.
I'm gonna complete it. Working hard.
You go in.
I feel like.
And then this can you see it well?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Megan.
What?
Oh, no. All right, okay, all right.
Try to do this
video. Help you.
How do you do it so well the first time?
As long as you have the points stabilized, you
can't be scared.
That's true, right?
There you go.
There you go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Work. Eddie found it. You're hinging them all?
Yes.
And it's gonna, in theory? Okay. I'm excited. Build off of each corner some little
piece like hold on
the box, and this just kind of rests on it. Question is, you gotta think about that. This is the physics part about the weight of the bear. Exactly, but that side doesn't. What if you took a big one and just brought it out further? Now you actually have more room.
Or should we just like put this all down and just be able to move that one?
Move which one?
Like just that.
Should we?
Do you want to just like keep the solid back?
Yeah, you know? It might be better.
I mean, if you did this, you could just try. Like, we put a 3-inch screw all the way through. Yeah, but use the same amount. You actually use more wood if you have to put another piece in. Use less wood. Use this and half of that to do that.
I only do big rolls.
You're not an actor.
Said who?
Said me.
You don't define me.
Yes, I do.
No.
I don't like cameras.
You're going to Hollywood.
Why are they so long?
You never seen it that long?
You have to drill them at an angle, okay?
Not on the nail. This is it for me. I stay behind the camera.
I'm gonna take it. Oh, thank you.
Wait, why?
We don't have any. You have two.
How do you feel?
Honestly, I just got from one to... No, I'm kidding, no. I don't really care. It's not that deep.
Rachel, how does it feel to take it?
Well, I think it's reasonable. Yeah, because they had two, and we had.
You were just shady off camera.
Is it level?
What can I say? Someone get the sunglasses.
Damn, it feels good to be a gangster.
Sorry, I'm not a film nerd.
Give me my camera back.
You're such a nerd.
Give me my camera back.
Nope.
Give me my camera.
Tell him.
I'm gonna kill you.
If I die, you know who it is.
No. You missed it.
I did.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
How's it going?
Good. We're getting our roof on.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Raise the roof, you know. Just get ready for work. For me, I be work. You see me do me da. Just tell me about that work. When you walk out, na.
Mia, you're not invited. I'm kidding.
Ding dong.
Sorry, we're not home. Not gonna narrate me, Mia?
Wait, I just have a question.
As Gabe angrily looks at me and says, you're gonna narrate me, Mia? So what is this for?
An extension.
These are the ones.
Drawing this whole thing out because it's crap.
I'm stupid.
What happened?
It's abstract.
So what is happening?
Yeah, that's a great question. I really wish that I knew what was going on.
How do you feel?
Oh my god, are you okay? Yeah. I'm so sorry.
Okay, you need to get done at work, come over. We just need to slow the motion. Don't get out of the way to no one. Long distance, I need you. When I see potential, I just gotta see it through. If you had a twin, I would still choose you. I don't wanna rush into it if it's too soon, but I know you need.
Go, go,
we need the hinges too.
Don't
we? Just use this one?
No, James, it wasn't. James, I knew it wasn't, James.
I'm pretty sure it was.
No, James, it wasn't, because when I switched, it went to reverse, James.
We'll just use the rest of this. It's honestly sturdier. I'm over it. Imagine, I just went, bah, just a gorilla tape shirt.
Do it.
Do it. Yeah. When you want me to gorilla tape your camera?
Yeah, do it.
This is the, okay.
11:45. We'll move these to the courtyard. I'll order pizza. We'll hang in the courtyard for an hour in our shelters for pizza. Oh. Hopefully it's not raining, but if it does, you have a shelter. Don't worry about it.
You're ugly.
What did you say?
Don't even.
Not today. Not today, Satan.
You have a lantern inside. How is this pillow going?
I think it's going really good. We just need a lot more newspaper.
We can make this a chandelier.
Huh?
Julia's ideas.
Yep.
And then Megan's like...
Julia decor. Welcome everybody. I'm gonna make a
small. You gonna take it? You going out the door? You wanna go out?
Yes, please.
Wait, why are we going through the...
Mr. Walsh has to go through the auto shop, but I don't know why.
Because you can't get through a regular door?
Shots until you're wrong. We just need a face to face.
Can you open the door?
I was locked out. One, two, three. Move that shelter. Woo. Shelter. Yeah. Kick and shake my legs.
Open right now. That's ridiculous.
So what's our issue?
Everything. The doorway is too small.
Life alert.
You can pick a time and a place. You'll spend some time away. Now you need to forward and give me all the work.
Reporting live from Nedlum's workshop, the Blue Jays. Currently, we have James Mack here disassembling our beautiful masterpiece because it doesn't fit through the... because it doesn't fit through the door. We got lost on the way here.
What are they doing?
Plot twist, ready? Record my face. Dun 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 dun. Dun 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 dun.
So what are we doing right now?
What kind of-
kind of cool.
Yes, that's the factor. That's the win factor, right?
I blame the plastic. A little bit. Yeah, it's a little bit dirty.
Go, Caroline, go.
When it's a sail again?
No, on the support.
Can we turn it into a square?
The support, because you don't have a home?
We do, it's over there, Nia.
Where is your shelter, to be honest?
Their shelter's right there.
We're gonna put it on the side. This one made it out the door, but didn't factor in wind.
Wind is an issue.
Yeah.
So you're friends with Jason Segel's
cousin.
Why are you bragging?
I'm just saying, I was at Jason Segel's wedding.
Who's Jason Segel?
It's bragging. Great,
I love you, man. Freaks and Geeks. Okay, like at this point. Like,
Freaks and Geeks?
Freaks and Geeks?
I never
Geeks,
watched
the
that.
Drummer guy? Oh, it's a good movie. Let's get back to the show.
I'll speak for the group. Sorry, guys. This is Caroline. My name is Bryn. This is Caitlin. This is Julia. And this is James. And together, we form the Blue Jays.
We did not expect it to not fit through the door. And that was very unfortunate.
We never would have imagined our shelter would come out this good.
No, but she's
very versatile, multi-purpose.
Mobile. It can move. The toughest part, I think, was everything. The whole thing.
Fitting through the door.
No, I really think that the toughest part was finding something that would stay up. The other group seemed to have done it, but we didn't. The whole nine yards. Actually, it was the day where we did the abstract thing and it fell.
Yeah.
And we had to change the entire thing.
Hi, I'm Tori.
Hi, I'm Christina.
I'm Vivian.
My name is Rachel.
I'm Anna.
I'm Alicia.
And we're the Peacocks. Woo!
Peacocks!
I think the most stressful part was probably the beginning, measure. Right?
Yeah.
In the beginning, we had to measure it and like find out what structure we wanted and like how we want the tack pieces together.
Initially at first, but then after a while, we got the hang of it and we just was like banging it out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're very more than satisfied.
I'm Megan.
I'm Julia.
I'm Lynn.
I'm Vivian.
I'm Kelly.
Hey! With the pigeons! Hello.
Pigeons are not Woo. Exciting.
Probably
that, what
around.
Just happened?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. She fell on.
I fell. I was trying to decorate, you know, add some flowers.
I wasn't stressed, though.
Walking around the entire school
oh
was more stressful.
Oh, my. Yeah, because yeah. we went the wrong way.
Yeah.
Hell yes. Yeah.
The extension, probably.
Yeah.
Why'd you guys make an extension?
Walsh told us to. We had extra wood.
Yeah.
And not a lot and a lot of time to play with. So he was like, build an extension.
Thanks, Nia. Yeah.
Welcome to our crib.
At my crib.
Hi, right, I'm Gabe.
Hello.
I'm Mackenzie.
I'm Edward.
Beatrice and Clev could not be here right now, but they're here in spirit. So we are the Flamingos. And Star Refuge.
Getting it together.
So honestly, we spent more days on thinking about the concept than actually building it. We thought the concept was pretty nice after, and inside it seemed really nice.
Yeah, but then we came out and it was really windy.
Yeah, it was really windy.
And our product turned into a sail.
And basically our thing was cracking, falling apart. The concept.
Anything about it though?
Well, we spent a couple days like wondering how the hinges would work, but then we got it together.
Yeah, because we put hinges on all four corners and it folds together.
And if there was going to be a roof or a floor.
I don't have anything to say.
I'd say that we pulled together with the efforts of our classmates and Mr. Walsh. And with their help, it became successful. And without them, I'm not sure what we would have done. So thank you, classmates. Thank you, Mr. Walsh.
It seems about a ball on us.